Welcome. This is concert number 7. We only have one more left after tonight, and we're so glad to see so many of you here again tonight. A lot of familiar faces from other concerts. Thank you so much for coming. We have a great concert prepared for you tonight. One of my favorite pieces is A Suite of Old American Dances. I hope you enjoy that. We've got a clarinet soloist. We've got a guest conductor who's a new faculty member at Wartburg coming up. And even a little Rolling Stone, so you can kind of get your groove on or whatever that is. So would you please stand and join us in the Star Spangled Banner.
Good evening, everybody. As Julie said, welcome to Concert 7 and yet another windy week for the band. But they always manage to get all their music in order, and we're so lucky to have you all here this evening. This evening is kind of it's a little bit Art of the Transcription. We'll talk about that here in a little bit. And then, as Julie said, the Rolling Stones are celebrating their 60th birthday this year, and y'all can take that as you want. So we'll talk about that when we get there too. Our first piece this evening is a piece entitled Country Gardens. It's based on a folk tune written by Percy Grainger. We haven't done much Grainger this year, so we're making up for that right now. And actually, this was arranged by Sousa. Sousa heard this on a player piano roll, and then orchestrated it, basically assigned band instruments to the songs that he heard. So you're gonna hear basically, I think it's like 6 or 7 verses of the same tune, but just orchestrated differently. So different parts of the band will play it at different times. And so this is a really neat arrangement. There's actually a letter out there that Sousa wrote to Grainger about the process, saying, you know, I've arranged some of your tunes. I heard this one on a player piano and I just had to do it. Oh, and by the way, you're not gonna get any royalties from it. And I think Grainger was okay with that. So this is Country Gardens.
Thank you.
Sorry, it's like I'm grabbing a hymnal. We all turn to page, and we'll all sing together. Was that Granger piece just really cute? You're like, oh, I really like hearing that group of instruments. Oh, no, it's a different group. They just switched all over the place. So now we got something, as they say, kind of completely different, but along the same lines, in that you're going to hear different colors of instruments of different groups. Robert Russell Bennett was very, very well known in the 40s, 50s for scoring musicals. So basically orchestration of various musicals. And the story goes that he went to a concert of the Goldman Band, and that was kind of his first experience hearing a concert band. He was working with orchestras and jazz bands and jazz combos, and he heard the concert band, and I have this here to give you the quote here. He said, his wife, Louise and I went to the concert, and I suddenly thought of all the beautiful sounds the American concert band could make that it hadn't yet made. This was like 1947-ish when he was at this concert. He continues on, that doesn't mean that the unmade sounds passed in review in my mind at all, but the sounds they made were so new to me after all my years with orchestra, dance bands, and tiny jazz combos that my pen was practically jumping out of my pocket, begging me to give this great big instrument some more music to play. And so he developed this suite of old American dances that we're about to play kind of around 1950. He had to kind of do it when he was working on all these other musicals. So you're going to hear kind of that musical influence in these movements. There's five movements, and we'd be here for about a half hour if we did all five. So you're welcome that we're only doing three of those this evening. So we're going to do the Western One Step. We're going to do a little Schottische for you featuring the woodwinds, and then a little cakewalk at the end. So this is three movements from the suite of old American dances.
Thank you.
So if you were here last week, you heard Mr. Mark Faulkner, who's the vocal director over at Grundy Center, and we alluded to that we thought we'd take a couple concerts and feature some of our local music teachers, not just at the college level, but in our high school level and middle school level with Mark. And then this week, we're featuring one of our general music teachers here in the area. Christine Grimm has taught at St. Pat's for the last 12 years. K8 General Music over at St. Pat's. And I don't know if her little students know this, but she's a phenomenal clarinet player. And we're gonna show her off a little bit tonight. This piece that she's gonna play is called Clarinet on the Town. And if you ever thought, oh, I wonder what a clarinet does when it's out on the town, you've never thought that, so don't even ponder that in your mind at all. This is what it might sound like. I doubt it, but we're going to play it anyway. But Christine's really great, and we hope you really enjoy Clarinet on the Town.
Thank you.
That's what a clarinet on the town sounds like, apparently. Hey, Christine did a great job. One more time, Christine Grimm.
Okay, now it's time in our program where we thank those people. And while I'm doing that, if there's any kids who want to be in our Children's March, I can have you come down here now and get ready to do our Children's March, okay? All right, we'd like to thank the City of Waterloo for all of our funding for our concert series. And to you folks who helped donate, it's been great. We've had some great donations this year, and that really helps the band. Ed Stoffer is our videographer. Jason Rubin is our photographer. The Center of the Arts staff sets up stuff for us and takes care of us for rehearsals and everything. And if you're still interested in making contributions, you can put them in the box up there or send them to us with that address that's on the program, or look us up on our website, www.waterlooband.ia.org. And don't forget about the Cedar Falls concert on Tuesday night in Overmont Park. It's their finale concert, and they're going to be doing, I believe, the 1812. So I'm going to check that out. Also, our last concert is next week. That's our finale, and you can kind of get yourself ready for Irish Fest, because we're going to do a lot of Irish music. Along with that, we're going to do that tribute to the Sullivan Brothers, We Stick Together, and Kelly Sullivan will be narrating that piece, along with the composer, Paul Baranski, will be conducting that. So that'll be an exciting thing to come see. So bring lots of people to come and see it, okay? All right, great. All right, kids. Oh, I've got a good group tonight. This is awesome. Oh, and you're back. I love your smile. It is awesome. Okay, today we're going to do a march called Colonel Bogey. Do you think that's a silly name? It is kind of a silly name, isn't it? Well, actually, it's kind of funny. The guy got the idea from somebody who liked to whistle. Do you like to whistle? Yeah. I have a hard time whistling, too. But, you know, there's an instrument in the band that kind of sounds like a whistle. Do you know which one that would be? It's the piccolo. Or the flute. Can one of you guys play that little tune for us at the beginning? I bet you all recognize it now, don't you? Yes, from the movie The Bridge Over the River Kwai. Anyway, it started out, those first two notes, was actually, this is what I read, we'll see if it's true or not, but there was this guy who liked to golf, and instead of yelling four, he whistled those first two notes. Who knows? But that's what it got the idea to do it. So, and Colonel Bogey isn't Bogey, have something to do with golf. So anyway, kind of fun facts to know. So we're gonna march to Colonel Bogey. Thank you.
How about one more time for our Colonel Bogey Marchers?
Yeah.
Our next piece is the quintessential slow piece of the concert. It's entitled Hymn Tune Rhapsody. It's based on the hymn Softly and Tenderly. This one has a little twist to it, though. It has a, kind of that slow beginning, but in the middle, well, we're going to throw a little wrench in the mix here, but it's a really cool effect. It starts kind of in the percussion, but it builds into this little, like, it's kind of a prelude to next week's Irish concert, if you will. So this is the hymn tune, Rhapsody, based on the hymn Softly and Tenderly.
Thank you.
So as Julie mentioned earlier, we have a guest conductor again this week. And it's so much fun to watch other conductors work with this group and steal all their ideas and claim them as our own. And tonight we have a new friend with us. This past year, our band director, Edward Warburg, retired, and so we conducted a search, and I think we hit it right on the head. We got a real winner here. And so tonight he's going to guest conduct the Fairest of the Fair, great Sousa March. They rehearsed it for 3 hours last night, and we think it's going to be really close. I mean, they're going to give it their best shot. It's going to be really great. He comes to us from California, from Los Angeles, so you can come up afterwards like good Midwestern friends and say, do you know so-and-so from Los Angeles? And he'll say, probably not. He's got relatives in Iowa, up in Cresco, right? And your mom's from Minnesota, so you can talk to him about that afterwards as well. That'll be great. So we're pleased to have a new friend of the band with us this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Professor Jeff DeSerrier.
Good evening, everyone. I'm so glad to be here tonight. This is my first concert in Iowa, and I'm so grateful to Scott for the invitation, and also to the band to allow me to stand in front of them tonight. So Fairest of the Fair, easily one of Sousa's greatest marches. I'd even put it in the top five. But it has sort of an interesting story, as most of Sousa's marches do. So the Fairest of the Fair refers to a young woman he saw at the Boston Food Fair. And he just couldn't get her out of his mind. And so he decided that when he was going to come back to the Boston Food Fair in 1908, that he would put her beautiful appearance in the context of a march. How many ladies out there would love a march written about them? Yeah. So that's early 20th century love right there. But anyways, he ended up writing this march in 1908. They had the Sousa Band, which was kind of the rock band of the early 20th century. I mean, they would have tens of thousands of people to go see them. Had a 20-day stint at the Boston Food Fair, so they played this march quite a bit. Another little bit about this march was that Sousa had completed the march, but their librarian did not finish completing writing out the parts and forgot about it, and on the train ride over to Boston realized as they were going through the program that they didn't have parts for the band. And so on the night before the premiere, the librarian sat on a train and wrote out all the parts, and Sousa, realizing that the librarian felt really terrible about this, but stayed up all night to write all the parts out for him, gave him an extra $50, which was 2 weeks worth of salary for a librarian then. So anyways, I hope you enjoy John Philip Sousa's The Fairest of the Fair. Thank you.
I think we'll keep them. What do you think? Thanks, Jeff. Appreciate it.
Yeah.
All right, as promised, maybe not. Last week we thought ABBA was such a great hit. We're going to go 10 years before that even further and bring you some Rolling Stones. Before we do that, this is my last concert conducting for the season. Danny's back next week, so I want to take this opportunity to thank the board and the librarians. You have no idea what these folks do for this group. It's really wonderful. The band, I mean, We rehearse for 2 hours on Wednesday evenings, and they do this. It's just phenomenal. So, Dan. And there's one person that's really super duper behind the scenes, and I don't think we'd all be here if this person didn't do the great service that she does for this organization. Julie Anderson has run the. Yep. This whole thing kind of starts in February when we get that email from Julie Anderson and we all go, oh no, because we know we have to get started. But then we get together and we're so excited because we're like, oh, we can do this, we're going to do that, we're going to do this and the other thing. And then it goes by so fast in the summer. But Julie coordinates with the Center for the Arts. She coordinates with Melody Parker at the Courier. She coordinates with all of us. It's just really phenomenal. So can we one more time for Julie for all her work? Julie, I told Danny to bring flowers next week.
He'll, okay.
So I'll make him pay for them too.
I'll act surprised.
So the tunes you're going to hear, Paint It Black, Ruby Tuesday, and of course we have to hear Can't Get No Satisfaction. This is the Rolling Stones and their 60th birthday, believe it or not. I wonder what that makes Mick Jagger. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay. Here we go.